Hello everyone, Tina here. I hope your day is going wonderful. Thank you so much for joining me. Well, today we're going to create a couple of cards. We're using the Hero Arts Bi-Monthly Hero Kit. This is what the kit looks like. It's pretty neat. It comes in this nice little vinyl pouch. Okay, I am super excited about this kit because of everything that it can do. Now, I was so excited. I already separated my dies here, but this is your 6x6 background cling stamp. It's red rubber, which is really nice. There's roses on here, some floral sprigs, there's some bumblebees, and I'm excited, you know why? Because the dies that we get, there are three frame cut. We'll call these frame cuts. Now these dies will cut out, if you find the flower in here, it's this one, but this will die cut out the flower that is in your background. So you can layer, which I love because, you know, I love layering. But I thought that was genius that you can cut out your flower in there. This is a two flower sprig. Whoops. And this one will cut out a flower in here also. This flower here, let me turn it so you can see, with the two petals, this will die cut out this one. How nice is that? And same with the bumblebee. There's lots of different shapes of bumblebees. You want to find the one that is has the wings opened up, and you can die cut that. There's a few of them, but you can die cut out the bumblebees also. So that is super neat. Now, you get a sentiment die. This says amazing. And then you get the shadow or the outline. I die cut it out to show you what it looked like. So this is the shadow. And then such a pretty font. This is your amazing. And if you layer them together, you have a pretty amazing die. So, or a pretty amazing sentiment, I should say. Not die. But there is your dies this month. So five in total. Two of them are sentiment based, and then the other ones are floral based that will go with your background. Now, there's more, and I'm excited to share with you the stencil. Now, this is a three-piece stencil set, three layers. There is Hero Arts' name on the bottom, so you know which way to put it. You will start with your first layer, and you can color in your background. How neat is that? So you can color it in and then die cut it out. Well, some of the images in here, but I thought that was super neat. And then you get a second image that will create a detail layer, which is really pretty. And then you get the leaf layer. So how cool is that? I am excited. And then there are little squares in the corner that are bullet points. So if you color those in with your inks, you know exactly where to line them up every time. You would just line up your next stencil with the ink mark on the corners. And there's another stamp set that goes with the amazing secondary sentiments. And there's a few that are not secondary, like you could use I love you or thank you for everything. But the rest of them, you can build your sentiments. So you have amazing. So you can, for example, put mom, you're amazing. Or you could put have an amazing birthday. So you could kind of build your sentiments. And this is a 3x4 stamp, clear stamp set. So that's included. You also get some enamel stickers. There are several different styles in here. Circles, hearts, and teardrops. And then you get three mini ink cubes. Mini Hero Hues. Candy apple. You know, let's swatch them out so you can see. Grab some cardstock. This is Rose Matter. If I can open it up here. That's a real pretty, like a fuchsia. You get cotton candy, real pretty pink. And then you also get green apple. So really pretty color palette. And those are your inks that are included. And then you also get a blending brush, which are super duper soft. Love this. So you can do your stenciling with your brush. So lots in this kit, and I am super excited to jump in and create some card projects. I'm going to set these aside. And you know what? For my inks today, I'm going to switch out the colors. I love the colors. I'm going to use green apple and cotton candy, but the rose matter, I just want to switch it up and use some blues and yellows and teals. So from my stash, I'm bringing in some reactive inks, but I'm bringing in a Blue Hawaii, a Pool Party. I'm going to actually blend these two together. I'm bringing in Lemon Drop, and I'm going to blend my cotton candy with that, and then I'll use this for my leaves. So bringing in a couple extra inks from my stash today. So I have a couple pieces of cardstock here. These are 6x6. I thought it would be easier to do a 6x6. And then I have extra too. Extra's always nice. I'm gonna bring in my my Misty, and we'll remove their mouse pad here, and we'll put our background stamp inside of our Misty in that corner. Pick it up with the lid. I like to tape down my backgrounds. So what I do is I add adhesive behind the back, and then I take my panel, and then I'll put it on my card or on my background, and I'll flip over my Misty backwards. That way I know exactly where it's positioned, and we are good to go. What we're going to start off doing is take some intense black ink, and I'm going to go over my background. Oh, how pretty. Okay, so one panel is done, and I am going to repeat the process one more time. Isn't that gorgeous? So I'll just go ahead and stamp one more in here. Okay, so we have two panels that are inked up. We'll set these aside. I'm going to go ahead and clean off. Nice thing too about the red rubber is it cleans off so easy. And while we have my Misty out, I'm going to remove this background stamp. Let's put our index back on here. And then in my stash, I have another background stamp. This is the script background. And we're going to be using this on our project today too. So I'm going to stamp this a couple times. Making sure it's right side up. So we have two backgrounds with this real pretty script. I did two of these too. I'm going to go ahead and take my Misty and set this aside. And now we are going to do a little bit of coloring. Okay, we're going to take our stencils. I had already put Pixie Spray behind my stencil, so we are ready to go. And we're going to start off with our first layer. Before I do my first layer, I want to make sure that all of my stencils, I know exactly what corner is right side up. So I'm using a Sharpie, and I'm just, actually, yeah, it stays on there. Layer one. Okay, this is layer one, and I'm just putting a little arrow telling me that's the right corner. And then this is layer two. And I'm just going to put an arrow up here. You want to make sure when you do this, you use a permanent marker. And then layer number three, I'm making sure it's the right way. To know that it's right side up, there is Hero Art's name down here in the bottom right corner. You can use that as a guide, but sometimes it's hard for me to see. So I'm just going to put some bold black ink on here to make it easier. Now we're going to take our first layer. I'm going to zoom in because it's pretty neat how this is working. First layer, you just line it up, and very easy to line up. That's what I love about this. And I'm going to start with my Lemon Drop. And for this, I'm using my finger daubers. And I'm going to go over the large flowers, or we can call them roses, with my Lemon Drop. Oops. So once we have our lemon drop done, I'm going to go in with Pool Party, and I'm using another finger dauber, and then I'm going to go over these, sorry about my phone, I'm going to go over these smaller flowers. Now when you get to the flowers that are around your larger flower, since we're doing a two-tone on this very first stencil, I'm going to use some scratch paper and just cover up those flowers so I don't get my teal and my yellow, because of course it's going to make green, and I don't think we want green flowers. So to do that, it's very easy. So we got one more over there. So we have our Pool Party over all of the smaller flowers. Now we have the two little sprigs that are V-shaped here and here. And for those, I'm going to be using Blue Hawaii. I'll use my finger dauber for those as well. And again, I'm just going to kind of mask off the areas that I don't want to hit with my Blue Hawaii. What I'm going to do next is take a towel, and I like to go over my stencil while it's on my cardstock. I've mentioned this before. To me, it's just easier, but when you do this, you want to make sure that you are not going over your yellow flowers, because you'll transfer your ink over your yellow roses. Okay, for the most part, we're cleaned up. good deal. Now we get to do our first layer reveal. Ta-dum! How neat is that? Next, what we're gonna do is take our second layer, and we are going to line it up. We'll line up our second layer. This one's going to be pretty easy. So I'm going to go ahead and take my Blue Hawaii and my finger dauber, and I'm going to go over the smaller flowers with this, creating a two-tone. And again, if I don't want it to hit my yellow flowers, I'm just going to cover it up with my my scratch paper here, because I don't kind of trust myself doing this. There's not too many. There is six that we were going to color in with the smaller ones. And then I'm going to take my towel, and I'm going to go ahead and clean off my stencil. And we're going to bring in our cotton candy. This one came with our kit. And I'm going to use the finger dauber for this. And we're going to go over our yellow roses. This is going to create a really pretty coral color, and it's really going to highlight those flowers. I'm going to go ahead and wipe off my stencil. And again, for me, it's just easier to wipe off. We'll go ahead and wipe off our stencil, and then we can do the reveal. How pretty is that? Okay, so, and your stencil's clean too. Okay, now we're going to take our third layer, line it up. If you don't have, I have tape behind my panel, but so it's stuck to my surface. Now I'm going to take my green apple and my blending brush, pick up some ink, and I'm going to go over. Oh, how easy and how pretty. I love how this just glides over your stencil. Okay, so that's done. I'm gonna wipe off my stencil again. And then while I have my stencil on here, I'm gonna take my Blue Hawaii reactive ink, and I'm just gonna go over the main leaves of my roses. And it's very easy to do. And then when you mix the blue Hawaii with the green, it just creates a real pretty deeper green. Like so. And then we get to do a reveal. How pretty is that? I just love this. And it was so easy, my goodness. One thing we do need to do is color in our bumblebees. And I'm just using my Y35 Copic marker and just going over the body. I think I got them all. That's another thing nice about the stencil is you won't miss anything. Like I would probably miss a few leaves and some flowers. But that is so pretty. I'm going to do the same exact thing with my next background panel. Okay, both of my panels are now done, and it didn't take me no time at all. I do have a little bit of adhesive in the back, so I'm just going to remove this because I'm going to run a few things through my die cutting machine, and if I have adhesive on my back panels, it really wants to stick to my cutting plates. Okay, so we're good to go. Now we're going to take our coordinating dies. And we're gonna die cut out some flowers. How pretty. I'm gonna find the one that works with this. And it looks like it's this one. I need some tape and we'll tape it down. Okay, so we have our florals die cut. And they die cut beautifully. Look at this. Excuse my inky fingers and my wounded hand. But there it is. Okay, now what we're going to do with this, we'll set this one aside. And what we're going to do with this panel is I'm going to take some of my nested rectangle dies. Now we're going to go ahead. So once we have our florals die cut, I'm going to set this panel aside along with my dies. And then what we're going to do is take two, a larger and a smaller rectangle die. These are Hero Arts nesting rectangle dies. And I'm going to run this. I want to create a thick frame, so I'm going to run this through my die cutting machine. And I'm going to remove this inside piece. And I'm going to keep this because we're going to use this for another card. And I'm going to keep this too. We'll use this for another card. Okay, now that we have our thick frame, we're going to work on our first card. I want a black mat on the inside of this. So what we're going to do is take some black cardstock, and I'm going to take a slightly smaller rectangle. You can see it's just slightly smaller, and I'm going to die cut this out with black cardstock. So now we have a frame. It doesn't have to be perfectly centered, but I'm going to go ahead and flip over this panel, and I'll add a little bit of adhesive. And then you better flip it over like this. And then I'm going to just mat that black behind this frame. And I think that's going to work out great. Once we have this done, I'm going to add foam adhesive behind. Okay, I had put adhesive behind my frame. So this is ready to go. And then I also stamped "I appreciate you" on black cardstock and heat embossed it, using that stamp from our smaller clear stamp. Next, what we're going to do is trim down a piece of our background, our scripty background. I just need a small piece. And then using my tape runner, when you trim this down, you want to make sure it's long enough to fit behind your, we're going to make a landscape style card, so you want to make sure it's long enough that it will fit behind your window, like so. So I adhered that, and then we're going to remove the release paper off of our foam adhesive. And then we're going to use our little floral here. I'm going to add a little adhesive to the top and then a little adhesive to the bottom. What I want to do is just kind of have it over the very top of our window. So it looks like it's kind of floating over the top. And then I'll take my I Appreciate You add adhesive to one side, the left side or the right side, and then I'll add some small foam squares. And then I'll add my bumblebee. Yeah, I think that's gonna work out nice here. And then this will finish off our very first card. I'm loving the way this is turning out. Now for my next card, I'm gonna go ahead and die cut out a few more bumblebees. I think I can get 1, 2, 3 more here, maybe 4. So let's go ahead and do some more die cutting. Okay, I die cut out a few more bumblebees. I actually die cut out 4 more, which is really nice. But I'm gonna use this last one for my last card. So we're gonna set that aside. Now I did stamp the sentiment on some black cardstock. This was actually the piece that was the inside of our frame here. So I'm not wasting it. I just stamped thank you for everything. And I kind of offset it so it was towards the top left. And then I also used my rectangle die and trimmed out a panel of that scripty background. We're gonna start by adhering our scripty background directly to our card base. This is gonna leave me a little, a nice border on my card. And then we're gonna layer our sentiment piece to this piece. This is also the piece that was left over from card number one when we die cut out the middle frame. I thought we would put this, actually it goes this way. I thought we'd put this to good use. So we're gonna go ahead and adhere this sentiment over that colorful rectangle, kind of layering both of these together. I'm gonna flip this around and add some foam adhesive behind my sentiment and add that to our card base. I'm going to add it a little bit towards the top. Good deal. Now we're going to take our die cut out flower. I'm going to add a foam square behind here. After we add our little bumblebees, we will finish embellishing this in just a minute, but we're going to go ahead and continue on to our third project. So that's card number 2. For my final card, I fishtailed some black cardstock, and this measures 1 3/4 inches wide, and then I fishtailed a banner using that scripty background. This measures 1 1/2 inches wide, and these flowers I fussy cut from the leftover piece of cardstock that we had. And I think I'm going to use my memento marker. And just to clean up the edges, since I did fussy cut to the line, I'm just going to add a little bit of black ink around the edges and die cut out some more flowers. You very well could. But this was just easier for me, and I don't mind fussy cutting. So also, we are going to take our leftover piece here and we are going to trim this down to a 1-inch strip. Let's just trim it. Maybe 1 1/4. 1 1/4 inch strips. Such a pretty pattern paper. I want to use every bit of it. It's so easy to make. Now I'm going to fishtail. So we're going to end up with 3 fishtail banners. I'm going to start by taking my black. And then the amazing is what I showed you during my unboxing. I just die cut out the amazing with white cardstock and then the outline with the same black. And then I did stamp to the most and daughter with black cardstock and heat embossed it with white embossing powder. I'm going to take my black cardstock and adhere that to my card base. We're going to layer a few of our banners here. I like doing this on cards. I just love the layers and the textures. So we'll add our first piece. Trim off this. And then my third layer. We'll add some adhesive, and then I'm going to add this. Overlapping here. Okay, so we have three banners. And then I'm going to take my amazing. I'm going to use my glue and add that to my background. Oh, and it just fits like a glove. I love these shadow dies. I think they're pretty neat. I do need to straighten this up a little bit. Good deal. I'm going to flip this around. We're going to add some foam tape behind here. I'm going to remove the release paper. Actually, let's add our flowers. No, let's add our... Yeah, let's add our flowers first. For our flowers, I'm going to pop them up with some dimensional circles. And I'm going to add one here to where the leaf is kind of overlapping, and then I'll add another one over here. And then I'll add my amazing. Okay, once we have our to the most and our daughter adhered, we have one bumblebee left, so we're going to go ahead and add. We're going to add that to our flower. I think that's a good spot. Okay, I'm going to grab all three of my projects that we created. And we are going to add a few of our enamel dots. I think the green is going to work really well with our projects today. So let's go ahead and add a few green ones. Okay. After we have our enamel dots, I used the circles for this card. For this one, I used the dewdrops or the clear tear ones. Tear shape, kind of looks like dew, really pretty. And I used the hearts for this one. And then last but not least, I'm gonna go in with some black Nouveau crystal drops. I'm gonna add some polka dots to the center of these flowers just to bring this black all together. And I'm going to scoot this bee over just a little bit. And we'll add some black dots to this flower center too. And then those are my projects today for Hero Arts. I thank you so much for joining me. I wish you a fantastic rest of your week. Have a great Easter holiday. Thanks for joining me. We will see you soon. Bye-bye.